Hey guys, before we get into this week's podcast with my good friend Glenny Balls of Barstool Sports, I just want to talk to you about Famigo, our sponsor. If you go to my Famigo page, you can get two exclusive songs that have never before been heard, and there will be more up periodically. There will be one up in a couple of weeks that nobody's ever heard. You can go to famigo.com/P/HueyMac to hear that. Subscribe, it's $5. Famigo is a really good company I've been fortunate enough to work with, and they've sponsored this podcast. If you're a creative, check them out. I think it's a really good opportunity for creatives just to kind of regain some power from the lack of pay from streaming. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this episode of Halfway Wholesome, and here we go.
I just want to confess my love for Miles Teller.
Oh, wow.
Dude, I love him so much.
He's the man.
He's the thing about Miles Teller is
he's
like
a close two for Jason Bateman for me.
I could watch Jason Bateman paint
Bateman
walls.
Guy.
You know what the thing about Teller is, though, is like I've been a Teller guy for 10 years now.
Day one. I'm a day one.
What's the rom-com?
Fucking that awkward moment. Yeah. It's a top tier.
Two Night Stand.
Two Night Stand is amazing.
I don't even want to talk about this because it pisses me off so much of how fucking he's so funny. He is great.
He is very funny, man.
It makes me sad that he doesn't do fucking comedies anymore because he's so funny.
Well, in
but I mean, that's like a good that's part of your acting
like
career.
Like 21 and Over. You ever seen 21 and Over?
Oh yeah, with a kid that parties all night.
Yeah. Awesome movie.
Great movie.
I don't know
no one talks about 21 and Over. It's awesome. He plays almost like
it got
the,
shadowed by Project.
It's like
X.
A frat movie kind
of. It's made by the same people as The Hangover, and it's like the whole gist of it is they're three best friends, the dude Skylar Astin from Pitch Perfect, Teller, and this guy Jeff Chang, their best friend Jeff Chang.
Yeah, it's great.
They go to visit Jeff Chang on like the night before his big job interview in college. And they just have like a crazy it's awesome.
They ruin it.
Teller plays almost like a Jonah Hill and Superbad-esque character. And he's just so fucking funny.
Kills it.
I miss when Teller does comedies. I wish Teller would do one more
Top
comedy.
Gun can we just appeal to Teller right now? We'll just make this the clip. Go back to comedy too, please.
I say it all the time.
I love all the dramas, but you are.
I get it. You
want to
be Vinny?
Well.
You want to be Vinny Pazienza? You want to be fucking Top Gun?
He's a great actor,
but he's very funny.
Just throw in a comedy once in a while.
Yeah, give us a rom com.
Give us a sequel. Yeah, Three Nights End, 22 and Over. Just give us a sequel, Teller.
That awkward moment again.
That other awkward moment.
That other awkward
more
moment.
Awkward moment.
Even Spectacular Now. You ever see Spectacular Now?
Oh, it's great. Perfect. Perfect. I think I've seen every Miles Teller movie, and I love everyone.
He's like he's my favorite actor by far. Like I'm a Teller stan.
This is where we're gonna start the podcast. just a cold open with our love for Miles Teller. Today we have my good close friend, the one and only.
Whoa. Glenny Balls.
Glenny Balls.
That was like a Bulls of 90s Bulls intro there. Thank you.
Is Glenn your real name?
Yeah.
It's not? Oh, okay.
G-L-E-N.
It'd be weird to have a fake name.
Yeah.
No, I mean like Glenn. Well, we call him Glenny.
Yeah.
I didn't. Could it be like Glennington?
But if you were
I don't
like,
know.
No, I'm Mark. You'd be like, what the fuck are you Glenny
Balls?
No,
I mean like Glenning. I don't know. My name's not Huey.
Fair point.
Yeah, G-L-E-N on the birth certificate.
Very fair.
Well done.
What's your last name?
Maduro.
I knew that, actually.
I did not know that.
Well,
that's,
congratulations. You didn't know. If you ever want to whack me, look me up.
Why does your brain go to whack?
Because he's an Italian monster.
I'm an Italian from Long Island.
Tony Soprano himself.
I'm an Italian guy from Long Island.
You are Tony Soprano.
I wish, dude. That's the goal. That's what I tell people all the time. Like, I went to my first wedding, not like of a friend, like 2 weeks ago. And I just put on my Snapchat story. I was like, please, everybody, just tell me like Tony Soprano. That's all I asked. Just tell me like Tony Soprano.
So let's get into it, Glenny. Where are you from originally?
Long Island.
He just said where he's from. What are you talking about?
I was born in Queens. I was born in Queens. I want the origin story. Lived in Corona, Queens until I was like 3, 4, and then moved to Long Island. So I'm from Long Island. I'm definitely a Long Island guy.
How old were you when you moved to Long Island?
Like 3 or 4.
Oh, so yeah.
I always say this whenever I talk about people, like where they're from. I think it's where you went to high school.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Where you went to high school is where you're from.
Because that's when you're like.
And that's your formative years. Yep. That's wherever you went to high school is where you're from. So I went to a Catholic high school on Long Island, and me and Maria both went there. Maria that from work as well. We both went there together.
Love her.
Oh, so you go that far back with her?
Yeah, she's my best girlfriend in the world. I mean, we've been friends there for probably 11 years.
Is that how did you get her the Barstool gig?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
So yeah.
Wasn't there just some controversy there?
Yeah. A little bit. Just a wee bit.
I don't pay that much attention.
It was just a wee bit. It was a wee bit. But I
saw it on Twitter.
It was a little awkward because I was both of them were maybe my best friends of the company. So that was a little awkward. We survived. We got past it.
Did young Glenny always want to be like an entertainer?
No. I don't know what I wanted to be. I didn't really have like a fucking plan. I just went to college. I fucking hated college. I went to UAlbany. I transferred home to friggin'
the Danes.
Go Great Danes, baby.
Good big lacrosse.
That was
big
lacrosse. I went when we had the Thompson brothers.
Yeah, I played a show there one time.
It was fun. Yeah. It was just like you had to be like in a frat to have fun. I don't like
you
the frat vibe.
Guy, yeah.
It's a terrible vibe.
So my
as somebody who was in one
frat vibes, you're saying?
Main story about the frats that I hate is I'll always tell a story. One of my best friends of the Skid Seasons clip, I don't really, whatever. But one of my best friends went to St. John's. He was in a frat at St. John's. And so St. John's in Queens, 20 minutes from where we're from.
Yeah.
And I always tell a story. He was friggin', we went to Belmont. They had like a frat day at Belmont Park, the racetrack.
Belmont 6, yeah.
And it was just like a frat. It was like to watch the Kentucky Derby. So all his frat friends were there. It was like, oh, come, we'll hang out. So we all go. And then we go back to his house, his house, though. His like family house, like where he's from, not his frat house. We go back to the family house, all the frat guys come back. So we're like, all right, this is our territory. This is where we hang out. And friggin' one of the frat kids who like I went to high school with, just this little like puny motherfucker. Like I asked one of the pledges, I'm like, hey, can you just go grab me a beer? Kid brings it back to me and I'm like, and the kid that I used to go to high school with that's also in the frat tells the pledge to like flick the can 100 times before he gives it to me. I'm like, dude, you're not in the frat house. You're in our domain right now. You're not flicking that can.
You don't have to do that.
You are not flicking the can.
It's so douchey.
And then he was like, bro, it's about fucking respect. And I'm like, what the fuck are you talking? He's not flicking the can.
Yeah, they brainwash you for real.
I'm like, what do you mean? I don't want him to fucking flick the can 100 times.
I've heard a lot of stories about my buddy.
I've never enjoyed that.
I was in one, so I actually experienced.
You weren't hazed though, because you were
I was
like,
famous.
Yeah, you already had like
all
some
my
fame.
Pledge brothers were like.
They all went through hell.
They all went through hell, and like brothers would like tell me to come to their room and like smoke a blunt with them, and it was fucking ridiculous.
Let's haze them.
I did to an extent. I'm not proud of it, but it's a thing that happened. But I fucking hate that culture. I actually, I have a scar on my lip from a dude from an opposing frat in college.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
He was tripping mushrooms.
First time I ever did mushrooms, I'm tripping fucking balls.
Yeah.
And I go to the bar like an idiot, because that's not something you're supposed to do when you're tripping balls on mushrooms. Because, you know, in college, like, it wasn't like we just had a little chocolate. Like, we ate a fucking egg.
You're eating caps.
Yeah.
I was, like, not seeing straight.
Not that micro.
And this kid comes up to me, and he was in a different frat. I didn't really know him, but he was like, yo, freestyle battle me right now. And I looked at him, and I was like, no, I'm not a fucking... I think I said
joke.
I'm not a pussy, or I'm not a loser or something.
Right.
I was like, dude, no, I'm not a fucking loser. I don't want to rap it at a bar with you.
I don't
want
to rap that
and the
you
kid
at a bar.
Just fucking takes my head and goes, boom, and headbutts me right in the fucking lip. And I'm tripping so hard, I don't realize, like, my lip cuts on my tooth, and I think it's dead skin.
I hate this part
so
of the
So I try to pull down the dead skin.
Stop.
And so I'm on shrooms with a dangling lip.
I'm not even opening my eyes right now. Yeah. I don't want to think about that.
That's
so I got it. I had to get a bunch of.
Can I ask
shit.
You a question? Is that like I know you went to West Virginia? Is the opposing frat culture like a thing there?
There were
majority of East Coast colleges I think are like that. Even if they're smaller frats, but they still think they like run the school.
Yeah,
like you know, frat culture in different schools.
But you gotta realize most of the dudes in frats are entitled kids. Like they're rich kids. Their parents have paved their whole life. Like it's there's already such a sense of entitlement from those
and it's
guys.
The pledging
like,
of it all. It's like
I have a lot of frat friends.
That's like
yeah. I mean, so do I.
A lot of frat friends.
I'm sure
I
have a lot of frat friends. I don't even know.
No hate, fellas.
I just don't like the whole.
I need a white claw. Anyone?
Look, yeah.
Sorry. Hi,
I would take one. Look, if you can't look back at your past and be like some of those things were a little douchey or those moments, then come on. Yeah. But I don't know how we got on that.
Because I was saying that.
I was like, here's Glenny Balls. Let's talk
about
frats for 20 minutes.
No, I was in college. That's why I left, because I was in college. And I was like, I just don't think the frat thing was for me.
Yeah.
So I transferred home. I went to Baruch College, which absolutely sucked. It was, I transferred home. Baruch is a business school on 23rd and Lexington. I live on Long Island. So And my first classes that week was, it was Monday, Wednesday, 7:20 a.m., and then Tuesday, Thursday, 7:50 a.m.
Oh, my God.
So
why
that was my first
semester
there.
To
it was fucking miserable. Miserable. And then luckily I got the interview at work and started working.
So you left school before you even finished a year at Albany?
I transferred to Baruch fall of 2016.
Okay.
I think. So I did a full semester at Baruch fall of 2016. And then right as the second semester started, like the summer semester, I got hired at work September 16th, 2016.
Okay.
So the second semester probably started late August.
Unreal.
And that was that second semester.
You got Barstool straight out of college, right?
I dropped out.
I was straight out of doing
it. I had just turned 20 years old.
You got it that early. I mean, I kind of know the story you and Caleb were kind of telling me the one night, but you...
I'll happily do one, yeah.
You interviewed with him?
Yeah.
And then...
Do you want the whole story? I'll give you the whole story.
Please.
I feel you've told it so many times.
I tell it so many times. I know how to tell it. But.
All right. Dude, this is Glenny Balls telling how he started at Barstool Sports.
So I'm freaking laying in bed one night, like late August, and I'm like, this sucks. Like, I hate my life. And I see Erica tweet out that that we need interns because Barstool is moving from Boston to New York. I'm a big Barstool fan, love Barstool. I instantly apply back. I get the interview somehow. And but I also think I'm emailing Erica at the time. It was really our office manager. So I'm exchanging emails with Erica at Barstool Sports, and I'm like, oh shit. Friggin' I think it's a business interview.
Yeah.
Because I'm emailing Erica.
Yeah.
So every Friday, though, I would have my stupid classes, and then I'd have a 20-minute lecture, per se, every Friday. Mm-hmm. So every Friday, for the three Fridays before that, my mom would drive me to the city. My mom doesn't work on Fridays. She would drive me to the city. Ow. She would drive me to the city, and we would fucking go have lunch. She would sit outside for the 20 minutes, and we'd go have lunch. So she drove me to the interview. She knew how friggin' nervous I was. She drives me to the interview. I do my stupid lecture. We go to the interview, and as we're driving over from Baruch to Barstool, I'm like looking at Snapchat. So we used to use Snapchat, and I see Caleb interviewing people, and I'm like, "Oh fuck!"
Caleb's doing his
bits, and I'm like, "Oh shit!" So I'm fucking freaked out. And as soon as I see that, my mom drops me off, and I'm like, "Claudia, drive away. Do not stay outside."
You call your mom by her name
sometimes. I call her Claudia sometimes.
It's a Long Island move.
Yeah,
for sure.
I'm like, "Claudia, drive away." So I go upstairs, and our old office is literally, you step off the elevator and everyone is sitting right there. You're right. Like, now we have a nice lobby and shit.
Yeah.
Our old office, though, you get off the elevator,
you're in the shit.
A big fan. So I get off the elevator and I see everybody. I'm like, my heart is beating so fucking fast. And then Caleb calls me over, and I don't even know what he was wearing. And he was just like hanging out, doing Caleb stuff.
Yeah.
And he's like, "Hey, how fast, like, are you fast?" And I'm like, "You know what, dude? Like, for my size, I am pretty fucking fast." And I am. Like, whenever I play fucking softball, people are shocked how quick this guy gets down the line.
The legs move, baby.
But so then he's like, "All right, prove it." So we go outside, and the whole time we're shitting bricks. I'm like, "Holy fuck, my mom is my mom still outside? I don't want my mom to still be outside." And then
Claudia's gonna watch you race down the
street. I don't want her to get out of the car. What's she gonna do? I get down there, and she didn't move. She's still there, and I'm fucking.
That's kind of crazy in the middle of New York, by the way.
My heart is beating so fast, and I run down the street. Cab's like, "Oh, you're hired," and then they brought me up to Dave, and that was fucking horrifying. And here we are, almost 6 years later.
And were you hired to write for Barstool?
I was just hired. Caleb was just like, "You're hired." I just started going to work in like a month. I did pretty well when we first started. And then Dave was like, "Oh, we're going to put you on fully as an intern, like with everybody." And then I went part-time, like part-time salary. And then once I dropped out of college, I went full-time.
Amazing.
I dropped out of college that June. Because it was weird. It was like a weird scene. Like, I was a fucking idiot. I was bad with math. I had to do like remedial math in college and shit. Yeah. What's happening out here? So I had to do like remedial math and should
Good
I stop?
Old LA.
They found it.
Yeah, let's do a pause.
Yeah.
It's going away. Welcome to the city
of
angels.
The Hollywood Hills was beautiful. But so friggin', I had to do remedial math because I was a fucking idiot. And I'm sitting in this math class, and it was so weird. Like, I'm just sitting here trying to remember how to do these answers and shit. And I'm like, I got Asa here texting me and like, "Come to the office." And I'm like, "What am I doing here? Like, why am I here?"
So that's how we met, I think, or we became cool. I think you DM'd me asking me to be on that podcast.
Yeah, me and Asa did a podcast called The Super Curious, where we just interviewed random people, and it was great.
I don't think we had ever met, but we were just like internet friends.
Yeah.
That's
we had a good amount of people, and we had Mr. Skin on there.
Oh,
God.
We had actually, I kind of want to go through the people we had if I can remember them. We had Adam Richman, the man versus food legend. We had Kirill. We had we had a Satanist. We had Mike Del Judice, a Long Island legend who it was started a Billy Joel cover band that is now in Billy Joel's real band.
Oh, that's pretty epic.
That's dope.
It was pretty sick. And who else did we have? Wow, man, I'm trying to think. Adam Richman was definitely my like biggest one though. I was excited. Yeah. That was like the first celebrity I met that I was like, holy shit. Like I used to have Man Richman shirts. I have his book. I was like, oh my God. I'm an Adam Richman stan. I love Adam Richman. But that was so we were doing that podcast with Asa, and then that just kind of fills it out. But that was fun.
What was that called?
It's called Super Curious. We would just be like curious about random shit. Honestly, Mr. Skin was a pretty sick interview. I also didn't get to interview Mr. Skin.
I never even thought he was a real person.
Oh, he's a real person.
Like, what?
I honestly don't know.
Flesh of the Stars.
Flesh of the Stars.
The nudity moments in every movie, and he puts them on his.
You never went on Mr. Skin as a kid?
No, I never did.
You never wanted Mr. Skin?
Honestly.
Dude.
Pretty creepy website.
I had an older brother with like VHS. Hardcore porn. So like, no, I
Mr.
just
Skin,
like
literally you would pull up on it and I would just type a Jennifer Aniston and be like, oh, she shows her ass in the breakup.
It just shows like from.
But then
knocked
you get, but then they had like premium. So that's this is a story I always tell. They had fucking like premium subscriptions, and on the show, Mr. Skin's like, oh, I'll give you a subscription. So Mr. Skin sends me a free subscription, but he doesn't send me the premium subscription, and I'm like, all right.
Like what? You want me just this?
This guy didn't send the premium.
Cheap bastard.
I was like, all right, I still have to buy it. Like I have to see it. So I bought it, and for like 5 months, I'm getting charged like $45 a month. What the fuck?
Oh,
is
shit.
This? 45? And it just came because it came with like a bundle. I was getting Mr. Skin. I was getting Playboy. I was getting Naked News, and I had no idea.
How did you become Barstool's
resident horny guy?
Resident horny guy.
So actually.
Was this the start of it?
The start of the horny guy, of being the resident horny guy, was. By the way, fun horny. I say this a lot of times.
Yeah.
I say a lot of times. There's two categories of horny. There's fun horny
and there's creepy horny.
We're fun horny on our show. But so like in January last year, I'm like, you know what? I think I'm very interested in OnlyFans. I think it's obviously, but I think it's like a very interesting business.
You've like, been like even that time we went to dinner and we all partied with like me, you, Caleb, Ben, and Noah, and everybody. You were pitching OnlyFans like. Subscribing to
no,
them.
I think it's like very interesting. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna start writing OnlyFans rankings. Like I think it's funny, like OnlyFans power rankings. I'll put like my five favorite OnlyFans girls of the week in a blog. So I did that for a few weeks, and I put this girl Mati Maroney as my number one, and then she DM'd me, and she was like, oh, if I'm in New York, you ever want to like do anything? Fine. So Marty, who I mentioned before,
do anything.
So Marty, who I mentioned, no, it's
I saw a clip of some girl asking you to fuck her, and you said no.
We'll get into that. So
we'll
so
there.
So Marty, who I answered, we talked about before. Marty had a show on Barstool called Marty, Terry, and Jerry, where he was like, he said basically, I just want to interview anyone. I want to interview random people. So Marty just texted me that, and I was like, all right, Marty's out on Wednesday, coming on Wednesday, and we'll just do like an interview. So like the show that Marty was doing, they were getting like maybe 10,000 views a day, which was fine.
Which is.
But then great. I had this girl Marty on, and I put it up, and we had like. Yeah, like 50,000 views. So I was like, all right, there's obviously something here.
There's obviously something here.
So I friggin' started the show OnlyStans. I figured it. I was like, oh, let's fucking start it. And we have we had Jeannie Eximon as our first guest. She was known for potentially stabbing her boyfriend.
We were with her last night.
Very nice.
We met her last night.
Very sweet girl.
Yeah.
Sweetheart. You may have met her last night. And so then we did that, and now we're like 10 episodes in. It's going pretty well.
Are you producing these shows yourself, or do you just kind of just?
We have a producer.
Okay.
We have a producer and editor.
You're lucky because doing this, I've learned how big of a fucking bitch it is.
Yeah.
Not easy.
It is an incredible amount of work.
But it's fun. It's been going well. We just had this girl Kelly Kay on last week, and the clips from her just absolutely popped up.
I mean, I've been seeing it everywhere.
She's the Super Bowl streaker.
Yeah. But she had a clip that popped off. It's all, I think it's like 8.3 million on my TikTok right now.
Yeah.
She friggin'
ended up
like eight. She was like, people misunderstood what she said.
Oh.
She said that I fucked my friend's brother, and then she was like, "All my brother's friends want to fuck me." She didn't say anything wrong.
Yeah,
and she was like, "Oh, they're in high school. Like, I don't mean to sound that way. Obviously, they're in high school. They want to fuck her.
Right. They took
like,
it.
The people thought that she was like fucking her brother's friends in high school. Instead of she said her friend's brother.
Yeah,
so I think that's why. I think that's why it like popped off so much.
All these young kids are like, "Oh my god."
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, it's been going well. We got a great. I think we're putting knowledge
as for her
on.
Streaking story. I have friends that work security for the Super Bowl.
Okay.
They said that she didn't even make it to the field.
No, she didn't.
She like, literally got down and they fucking whiffed her up.
And she was telling me, she was telling me.
She
was telling me she had months of fucking preparation and shit.
Yeah, she put all this prep in just to get shut down.
I think
down.
She said she got like to like the end of the end zone. That's all she got. That's all she got to. But I mean, I think actually this past week she had a New York Times interview outside of Hard Rock Stadium for it. So I guess good for her.
Wow, that's funny. That's cool. But I just had to say, security's tough.
His boys growing up like run the security for the Super Bowl and stuff like that. So,
yeah. When I heard the story, I was like, wait, I didn't hear about this. Like, I didn't remember this. So I sent it to them. I sent them the clip, and they told me, they're like, yeah, it happened for sure. But we got her before she didn't hit the field.
Nah, but she was great. And then we got Adam 22 on. We interviewed him last week, so we'll post that soon. And it's been fun.
When is our burger tasting video coming out?
What do we do?
We put a lot of effort into tasting
smash
burgers.
I just want to say that guy was a dick to me.
The cheese was phenomenal.
Stop, don't talk about my chef Greeny like that.
He loves you.
Tell he wasn't that much of a vibe.
I mean, I know Chef Greeny too. He's a good guy.
He blessed us with delicious American cheese.
And it was great cheese.
It was great. It was great.
You
it was great.
It was good.
It was great. But he was like, Glenn, come here.
Like, just didn't give a fuck about you whatsoever.
Glenn invited us to this thing, and he's like, yeah, Glenny.
That's like me. That was like me being Star Trek too. Like, I'm a Food Network whore. Yeah. I'm Star Trek by Food Network people.
Yeah, well, that's one of the connections that we made. Aaron May is one of our close friends.
Yeah, like, I fucking love Aaron May.
And Greeny's good friends. Yeah, how I met Greeny originally.
Yeah, I'm a Food Network whore. I guess Star Trek by weird people, and Food Network is definitely one of them.
Do you enjoy the traveling of the job? Because, just from my job,
travel a lot.
I travel a lot. Like, that shit's fucking taxing.
So the problem is, like, I'm a person that if I travel, I can't, like, just chill.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I have to go out and get fucked up.
That's the way to travel, though.
But it's a lot.
Yeah,
like, it's a lot.
I mean, last fall, me and Caleb, I think we put out 28 videos in 28 weeks, and we traveled every guest.
Yeah, you said. I mean,
that's
absurd. I think one of the last times I saw you guys, you were like, "We're taking a break from this,"
and now we're back.
And now you're back on it real quick.
But it's a lot of. I mean, it's obviously awesome. Like, I wouldn't trade it for the world. But it does weigh down on you. My main thing for me is, like, I'm trying to, like, obviously it doesn't look like it, but I'm always attempting to eat remotely healthy. So, like, it's eating healthy when you're traveling is.
I have never seen you remotely try to eat healthy when I'm with you.
It's a journey, Joe.
What do you mean?
God,
what do you mean? Yeah,
I feel like we're always eating burgers.
I actually shockingly eat very healthy.
Do you?
I believe it. I've lost like 35 pounds.
Let's go.
Fucking
F off, dog. I actually, like, I eat, like, literally when I travel, I try to just so. But that's the thing too. Like, I like to indulge in, like,
it's
like
so good hard.
Like, if I'm in New Orleans, I want to eat the jambalaya. If I'm in LA, I want to eat the tacos. If I'm in Chicago, I want to eat the Italian.
Wait, meals. LA is tacos?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, dude, we're very close to Mexico.
Yeah, that's true.
But,
that's a good point.
But that's the thing. Like, I love that shit. But what I've been trying to do, like, when I travel to places I've been to a lot, honestly, my life hack I've been doing, I just get there and I order just a bunch of fucking grilled nuggets from Chick-fil-A. And just eat the Chick-fil-A grilled nuggets. That's all I do.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, for the show, luckily, we basically travel to, like, the same places over and over.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we basically just go from LA to Miami to where else is a big one? Got a Texas, few Texases.
Nashville.
I wish we had more Nashvilles.
What has been your favorite show that you've done with Caleb? Like, are your number one Sundae conversation? Do you have a number one, or you have like a top three?
Or who you
well,
haven't?
I think the Kodak one is definitely the best one. My personal favorite though is Darius Rucker. I'm a huge Hootie
yeah,
the Blind.
That's fucking. That's
he was one of my like top people to like.
He asked I remember you saying he asked you to golf and you were like, I can't golf. So I just said no.
Like, Caleb was like, oh yeah, Darius, I guess it's the golf, and I was like, dude, I can't. I literally texted my mom. I was like, I need golf lessons. For Christmas. I can't have Hootie ask me to golf and me say no
and not be able to go golf.
So I literally I haven't done the lessons yet, but I have three golf lessons paid for. I got to go do them because I cannot go if. Fucking Darius Rucker.
He turned down Darius Hootie. He turned down fucking
Hootie. I can't
go
there and not know how to golf. Like,
no,
I only want to golf with you.
I got invited to Conan's golf tournament, and I wouldn't do it because I was like, I'm going
to
fucking blow.
You don't know how to do it. I feel like it's awkward. That's why I need to go to fucking.
Wait, you got invited to golf
when I was at TBS. They had an annual Conan golf tournament, and they put me on, and I was like,
I went golfing the other day with Carl Anthony Towns.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
The cat.
Where are you going?
Yeah. But, I mean,
we'll pause.
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
My bad.
I want to show you the, I know we're mid-podcast, but this is in the house. house, the different of the caps is insane. This thing might be like 10 years old.
I didn't realize.
No.
Hey, if there's another High Noon, will you grab it for
there's
me?
There's none.
We're out.
Oh, we're out.
This is none.
We're out alcohol. Okay.
I haven't eaten yet today.
What?
He's got tequila. And
all right, bring it on.
I'm not scared. I haven't eaten today.
I haven't eaten today either. We're hungover as shit, so we went to... Glenny dragged us to a club last night.
We went to Nightingale.
And now... I woke up and I was like, fuck.
We immediately woke up and started drinking.
I thought you had to pee. Oh, I'm...
There we go.
We're partying.
I feel like...
Sundae...
You're in business.
Is there any Sundae guest that you haven't gotten that you want to get? That's like a...
Billy Joel.
I mean, what I've been saying, I don't want to keep this up, but... I think Miles Teller would be a great guest.
Oh my goodness, Miles.
My friend Miles.
Wow.
I think Miles Teller would be a great guest.
Let's go.
Teller would be a great guest.
I told Caleb that. I was like, we DM each other. We're on Twitter friends. I could DM him. And he won't let me do it.
Wow.
Why?
I don't know.
Has Sundae conversation been, do you feel like, I don't know the right word here, but like you've gotten the most traction
by far.
Like,
by far.
Your name getting.
I was saying last night, like, Sundae conversation kind of like transcends bar. Like, it's, I think, like, more people know
it's like its own thing.
Yeah, it's almost like its own thing. It's, I mean, it's great. I love it, but definitely by far. It's like, it's so weird.
Yeah.
Why haven't you gotten a Soprano on there yet? You could probably reach out to Meadow.
I mean, Meadow
follows Jamie Lynn Siegler.
Does she?
She follows me on Instagram. Yeah.
Jamie.
Because I believe Robert Eiler, AJ, is a stoolie, and he was like, oh, Glenny Balls of Sopranos, Jamie Lynn Siegler did follow me. It was a big moment for me.
Can we just
I don't want to talk about this because obviously the of course number one guest of all time would be our sweet boy that's no longer with us.
yes, James Gandolfini. I just watched.
That's one. I think he would almost maybe top Billy Joel as my number one.
Wow.
If he was alive.
Really?
Wow.
Like, if I saw James Gandolfini, I would.
I
think that would maybe top Joel. That
I just watched Sopranos for the first time, and I feel like I was texting you the whole way.
I mean, it's
It's great.
So
it's great.
Good.
I didn't
it's
even
so
mind the ending. Everybody minds the ending. Just say AJ is the worst character in television history?
I say that all the time.
I'd say he's even worse
he
than
might
Skyler
be...
in fucking oh. Breaking
I would
Bad.
No,
she's
Wendy,
very bad.
He's worse than Wendy Bird.
The thing is, like, there's bad characters in shows where, like, I know they're bad, but I think they're great. Yep. AJ, I think, sucks in all facets.
Yeah.
Like
he's not
like,
even
like,
a good actor.
They didn't
like,
even write anything.
No, like, we love Robert Eiler, but I'm saying, like,
you get mad
actor.
When he's on screen.
I get mad when he's on screen. Like, when he comes home with his fucking eyebrow shaved and just being a bitch to Carmella, I'm like,
dude, it's the worst.
And then Tony's just a little bitch punishing him. But friggin', like, I think they're like Ralphie's a fucking cocksucker, but he's so good.
But
he's
the best character in Sopranos, I think.
Who do you think killed Tony?
So I have a crazy conspiracy theory.
Please, I want to hear it.
Yes. We're gonna get deep into
this. Yeah. Shirt is off.
Coming off for this one.
I have a crazy Tony Soprano conspiracy theory. Let me take a shot first.
Yeah, rip it.
Let's go.
He has to prepare.
So I tell people this all the time. They think I'm stupid. I think I'm kind of correct. I think Patsy Parisi killed Tony Soprano.
Okay.
Speak on that.
Why?
I'm pretty positive Patsy killed Tony.
I never liked Patsy.
No, fuck Patsy. So. The show, the whole show, Patsy had a hatred towards Tony because they killed his brother Phil.
Right.
Yep.
And then as Sopranos is winding down, I'm trying to think about all the details. I don't want to fuck you guys over. I'm trying to think about all the details. As
spoiler alert, if you've never seen Sopranos,
yeah. It came out 23 years ago. So
yeah. So
but
fuck off.
As the show is winding down, Meadow gets engaged to Patsy's son.
Yep.
And Sorry, I'm trying to process.
No, you're good.
So Meadow gets engaged to Patsy's son, and Patsy's other son is that fucking cocksucker at Rutgers with who's the other guy?
That fucking cocksucker,
Carlo Gervasi, and the other son. They're both their sons are the drug dealers at Rutgers. Are like hanging out with AJ, and Carlo testifies because they get caught. Carlo testifies, so Tony's probably automatically thinking they're going for Patsy next.
Yeah.
So in Patsy's brain. Tony's going to be coming for me, as Patsy's other son is also engaged to Meadow.
Whoa.
So I think that everyone's pretty much done. They squash a New York beef, obviously. We see them squash it. Everything's kind of done. Patsy is the only person left, pretty much, and he's thinking Tony's coming for me. If Carlo's testifying, Tony thinks I'm testifying, so Tony's going to be coming for me. And I think this is so stupid, but David Chase, the creator of The Sopranos, the showrunner, everything he puts in there is meant to be there. There's a scene, I think it's the second last episode or the last episode, where Tony and Carmela are having coffee with Meadow, the son, Patsy, and Patsy's wife. And they just show one quick look where Patsy looks up at Tony, and you can see he fucking hates Tony.
Mm-hmm.
I personally woke on that. I think Patsy killed
Tony. I like this. Well, I like this theory a lot.
Well, I just watched it for the first time because me and him were going to see the movie. Yeah. And I was like, I got to watch.
So unnecessary.
But David, he said in the thing, he's like, they asked him about the finale, and he's like, for the first time, he was like, I just assumed everybody knew Tony was dead.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the whole thing. David Chase has always said, it's there. If you want to find it, it's there. And everything is there if you want to find it. Like, forget it.
We gotta get an interview with that guy.
Because the whole thing is the bell.
I don't think that's the whole coming on this show.
He said
not this show, but someone, one of our friends.
He said many times that friggin' when he's in season 6, episode 1, Sopranos Home Movies, Tony's with Bobby at their upstate house, and they're talking about Bobby says, I feel like you don't even hear when it happens. So a few episodes before the end, I believe maybe 10 episodes probably, Silvio was with Jerry Torciano at a restaurant, and Jerry gets shot, and Silvio's sound goes out, he doesn't hear anything. So that like to let you know that you don't even hear it when it happens.
Right.
And then also Bobby, the whole time they're talking, you hear a bell in the background.
Yeah.
So
I read this theory too. Yeah.
You hear a bell in the background, and then in the final scene, everything, there's a bell happening every single time. Every single time. So the final scene, they're in Holston's. Every time a bell comes up, it switches from the door to Tony's perspective.
Right.
So the final time you hear the bell and it switches to Tony's perspective, which is nothing. It's black.
Silent,
you don't hear
right.
anything.
Fuck. Yeah. I mean, that show is, I thought it was the perfect ending. The first time I watched it, I was like that. It would have been disappointing if they gave you a definitive ending.
No, I agree. Because that's what people always say too, is like, what are the definitive endings? Tony gets killed. Tony goes to jail. Tony's no one wants to see that.
No one.
I think it's a great ending. I'm a very big fan of the ending. I mean, it's a perfect show. And you forget when you watched how funny it is.
Yeah.
I say all the time.
It's
just
hilarious.
I was telling her the other day, friggin' one of the funniest things in Sopranos. I have three Sopranos funniest moments of all time that I always say. First one is after Tony's mom dies, and he's calling Janice, and Janice doesn't want to come. She can't afford a plane ticket. He's like, Janice, she was your mother. and then obviously Christopher's intervention. When Carmela goes, we're all sitting there, and Carmela goes, I happen to know that you were high and my mother-in-law's wake, talking nothing but gibberish, nonstop for 20 minutes. And then it just cuts to Tony. He just goes, my mother's wake, Jesus Christ.
My
favorite one of all time. It's fucking so funny. It's like such like a passing thing that nobody realized it. It's like one of the final seasons. I forgot which one it was, but Janice has like a baby. And Tony walks into Janice's apartment like ready to scream at her. And Janice just goes, you're not going to say hello to your niece? And Tony just goes, how you doing, sweetheart? to like a one-month-old baby.
How you doing, sweetheart?
She's like, how you doing, hon? It's not so fucking funny. I have to find that clip. It makes me cry.
Oh, man. Being on The Sopranos, I wanted to touch on it, though. I feel like you don't get enough props for being a fucking great writer. Like, your blogs, I feel like you're jumping in my mind in moments where you did the fucking Chevrolet blog where you're like, I don't even know this car, and I'm going to buy 100 of them after that commercial.
Oh, after they did
the fucking Sopranos,
the Meadow and AJ Super Bowl commercial.
And like,
dude, I don't even know where I watched Super Bowl this year. And I just got so many texts about that. I thought I was.
All of us thought that.
I thought I was on Super Bowl commercial. Every people started texting me. I was like, they were like, holy shit, this ever streaming commercial. I was like, did they like put like a clip of me in the commercial? And I was freaking out. Then I was just like, no, it was just.
But I'm saying, like, the part of Barstool being blogging, like, your articles are like straight out of our minds sitting around, like, fuck, Glenny just said what I thought.
Oh, well,
I
appreciate
love that
shit. But hey, I love Sopranos. I'm like a weird brain person. I just like the things I like. I like Food Network. I like Sopranos. I like Entourage. And I like drinking. It's pretty much
simple, man.
I think that's why we get along.
I wish I had more
things I like a lot, too.
I will say, I think, gun to my head, if I had to pick Sopranos or Entourage, I think I'd pick Entourage.
Wow.
Entourage is good. Speaking of, we are friends with Kevin Connolly, who plays E.
Shout out Goal Sports, West 3rd Street.
Shout out Goal. He's been my karaoke partner for a long time. He's a good guy. I recently saw a Barstool and Kevin beef
Yes, Jersey
Can
Jerry.
Give me context on that?
I have no context because I feel awkward as the resident entourage lover.
Yeah.
I'm staying.
You're like, I like this guy, but
I'm like, I love Jerry, and I don't want to feel embarrassed for liking Entourage. Like I feel bad. And it's weird because like Entourage, like that's like my like
yeah
my thing. Like every time I fucking walk into a friggin' every time I come into LA, I posted yesterday my story. I go to Turner's Liquors on the friggin' on Sunset Boulevard. And I close my little story with the superhero. And I'm like, this is fucking dude.
I was supposed to take you to Goal to meet.
A person I'd be starstruck by. So the first ever person I was starstruck by in my life, I was at work and fucking Jerry Ferrara was there.
Mm-hmm.
Turtle, and I was like,
Oh my God. Same way. First celebrity I met in LA was fucking Jerry, and he was the nicest human.
He's sweet.
Like,
I played Xbox with him a bunch of times. I actually never met him in person. I was like, holy, fucking
Turtle. One time,
it's a unicorn.
The most starstruck I've probably ever been, and you have a similar story. Kevin invited me to his birthday party, and I walked in.
Oh, you've told me the story.
It's like maybe 30 people, but like in the midst of the people, it's like me, Toby Maguire, Orlando Bloom, Sloan, Emmanuel Kevin Conley, Leo.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what the fuck am I doing here? And Leo's like getting on the mic and he's like all hammered. He's like, happy fucking birthday, Kevin.
Leo?
Yeah, Leo. And
I think Leo's the only person that is like, he's transcended everything.
They have the best, like a way better Leo story than that.
We have a very close, like, family friend, cousin. Technically not our cousin, but she's our cousin. Her kids are actually Leo's god kids.
Okay.
They're not together anymore, but her baby daddy.
Her ex-husband,
excuse me. So I don't know how to say this properly, but is best friends with Leo growing up. They grew up together. They were close forever. And so we always, you know, we go to everything because she's our, you know, close friend.
All
we
her just, kids' birthdays.
Exactly. And we always knew that one day he was going to show up. And we're at like a, how old was she turning?
It was her 10th birthday.
It was her 10th
birthday. So we felt like it was going to be the one.
We're at like a 10-year-old birthday. Bring our gifts, everything. And the door opens up and I hear the little girl go, oh, Uncle Leo. And Norm and I, we like look over and we go, like, look at each other. We're like,
he's a guy you can't look at.
Yeah, it's hard to look at him. He's so good looking.
I love his movies. I'm not even saying I'm like a Leo. I'm not saying he's my favorite actor by any means, but he's just a guy that's like.
We both had to play it as cool as humanly possible.
Kicking my foot. I'm like, I know, dude.
He always wears West Virginia hats.
Does he really?
But only because he likes the colorway. Like, he's been asked, and he says that. And I saw him one time at Goal, just like, with the West Virginia hat, and I was like, oh my God, if I had a picture right now, this would go so crazy.
He's a person that if I was in the same room with him, I would, he's just the one person that transcends everything. Like,
yeah, for sure.
He's someone
just
you don't
like,
think you'll ever see.
I'm just going to like stand here and be a fly on the wall to this whole I'm going to take it all in.
And that's the thing. I don't mind. Like, I always tell people, ask me all the time, like, who I'm starstruck by. I got starstruck by like people I love. Like, if I'm in a room with Tom Cruise, couldn't care less.
Yeah.
But like,
I think
Jerry Ferrara.
I think if you saw fucking Tom Cruise, that would change real quick. Tom Cruise, it also transcends.
Kevin had a pretty good story about him at Matsuhisa. They were like, we're turning the corner, and he just like, they like literally both hit the corner, and they just hit each other hard. And he was like, because Tom's not a tall guy. He's like, sorry, man, my bad. And he looks at me, he's like, oh, shit, that was Tom Cruise. I just bodied.
I'm just get starstruck by weird people. Like, I've always said the people I've gotten starstruck by are just people I love. Like, I've gotten starstruck by Jerry Ferrara, the cast of Jersey Shore. Whenever the cast of Jersey Shore comes to work, I'm like,
that's a great
song. I put my head down. I'm like, I can't even look at these people right now.
Yeah.
Is there people, when I get really starstruck, I'm like, I can't even go up to them. I freak out. Artie Lang, I fucking love Artie Lang.
I don't think I've ever been a full... Leo was definitely one that I was like pretty excited about.
You're the king of LA.
I have a pretty good Owen Wilson.
You told me the Owen Wilson story, which is definitely someone of mine. So honestly, one low key white whale of mine.
Let's
is Vince
not
Vaughn.
Tell that story.
No, I'm not telling the story.
But low key white whale of mine is Vince Vaughn. I would be very starstruck with Vince Vaughn.
That would be tight.
Vince Vaughn would starstruck.
I did a concert with J. Cole one time in an arena, and we talked for like 5 minutes, and he was just like kind of giving me game and was so nice. And the whole time I was like, holy fuck,
that's awesome.
He was very nice.
He was like, giving me like game for like 5 minutes, and I was like, holy shit.
You saw him
like
on the rock step.
Yeah, he came in and was, because one of his, I think it was Earth Gang or maybe Jid.
Yeah.
They were performing at Roxy. I was upstairs like setting up the bar, and I'm like bopping through, and I, you have to go through like the back areas, and I walked through, and I was just like, oh shit. I was like, Cole, what up, man? How are you? He's like, I'm good, man. Like, what's good? I was like, I'm just working. Didn't know what to say. I got nervous. Like, put the stuff down. I came back out, and I like, I was like, I gotta get.
You showed him the tattoo too.
Yeah,
right? Yeah.
Beauty and the Struggle. Yeah.
The only other, I've been around Drake a couple times, like with Ovi Orion, and I've been like, holy shit, that's Drake. But I've never had the balls to speak to him.
Yeah. I haven't had a conversation with him, but I gave him a dap one time at Bootsy Bellows.
Yeah.
He was like blocked off in his corner. I'm like, what's up, brother?
So Noah, as a man about LA, like you're my LA guy. Whenever I come to LA, I'm like, oh, let me see what Noah's doing.
Whoa.
I feel like Noah runs the show.
He does. He is the mayor.
Don't ever say
I make the
Noah
decisions.
We have a group chat of us three.
It's a group chat. Talk to me. What do you got for
me? What's your top like LA? What's your top LA experience? Classic LA experience.
You know what makes Noah Noah? He's shameless.
Yeah.
Like he'll just like, don't like to ask for things or like ask favors, and Noah will just like straight up, like he'll, if he had Owen Wilson's number, he'd probably be like, yo, Owen, like, will you do me this solid?
See, but that's the thing though. I feel like Owen Wilson is so on the other line that like he likes that when people do that.
He's comfortable
with
Noah
all these people.
Is the king of testing the waters,
sure.
Even post tour managers,
oh,
like, what the fuck, man?
No, the funniest time was when we were backstage, and it's like one of their like head ladies. She's like, "Who are you?" And I was like, "Oh, I'm Noah. I'm
I was
just,
there
like, doing my thing." She's like, no, like, what makes you think that you can, like, the way you walk around back here, like you like run the show, like what do you think this is?" I was like, "Oh, I don't know. I'm just doing my thing.
Let me here."
Was that in San Diego?
I think so. It was just really funny. And, like, for an experience that I'd say is like one of my favorites. There's a lot. Definitely meeting Post, having some like experiences with him at On the Rocks.
You just met him. He's like all time great.
Yeah, actually, our video came out today with Post. Yeah. So go watch
all
that.
Time the best dude great
guy. He's one of the. Like, he's like probably the nicest guy we've had. I mean, he's one of the guys like he walked in, made sure he said hi, shook everybody's hand.
He's
everybody
uncomfortably nice.
Dude, yeah. He left like, me a $5,000 tip.
Yeah.
Just me solo, only bartender working. And he's like, yo, this machine's not letting me leave the tip, and I'm like, what do you mean? I'm like, dude, it's like type it in. He's like, no, like. It says it's too much. And I was like, what are you trying to leave me, dude? Like, chill. He's like, no, I want to take care of you. I'm like, how much? He's like, 5K. And my, like,
and you
heart,
shit your
my
pants
heart literally
and then,
just went straight through my body. And I was like, are you kidding me? He's like, no, I'm dead ass. So I'd, like, call my bosses and, like, figure out how to, like, make this go through on the computer. Nicest guy ever.
All-time great guy. And me and I just want to say, one of the last times I saw him, me and him wiped the floor with you two
not
in beer
true
pong.
At all.
Me and him wiped the floor with you two in beer
spread
pong.
This is we have footage. We
yeah, of me winning.
Up.
No. They beat us.
Both games.
Yeah, they beat us.
Really?
Me and Post wiped
lost
the floor with you two.
We lost that day.
I need to see game tape.
There's one video. Of
there's a video.
And
me and
they
him
got bringbacks on us, but
damn, that's embarrassing.
He is a good player. I'll give him that. He's got game.
Didn't he win the beer pong tournament during COVID?
The Mike.
Oh,
no, he didn't.
No, he did.
I thought he did.
No, he backed out.
Okay. Oh shit! Right.
Stud and them won that.
He made his own
game too.
I'm so bad.
I
used to be like remotely decent. My friends used to get in high school. My friends just told me Matt Harvey because I would just fucking like shuck the balls.
You're just fucking.
That was back when Matt Harvey was shucking too. But I suck now. When I play maybe twice a year and I'm fucking horrible every time I play.
I still have it.
I still got it.
I don't have it. I wish I had it. I have like a an oddly low. I'm decent. I'm not a good chugger. I'm a horrible chugger. But like something comes into me like competitiveness, like flip cup. Like if you gave me a
flip some cups.
If you gave me a full beer right now and said chug, I couldn't do it. But if we were playing flip cup, I could do it. Yeah. I think it's like a mind thing. I don't know what it is. But
you just don't have that Mamba mentality when it comes to drinking.
Oh, I got a Mamba mentality when it comes to drinking, trust me.
No, trust drinking me games.
Drinking, I mean, I love a good flip cup.
I'm just very competitive.
You know what annoys the fuck out of me with flip cup, though? I hate playing it. So many people flip, like, where, like, they're holding it here, and then, like, basically do the flip.
Yeah, they cheat.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's
I'm
cheaters
like,
out there.
I'm, like, hands on my back. I want to do it authentically. That's too much with flip cup, though.
Like, one of these.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's fucking such bullshit. So many people do it, and then like
for the next segment, we'll just be playing out, flip cup. Yeah.
And then when you call somebody out, they're just like, "Oh, we're just playing a game." Like,
no, what do you mean? Play the game, brother. Stop play it fucking right, asshole.
I mean, as long as the alcohol gets in my system, I don't give a fuck. But still, it's just it's for the principle of the whole thing. I don't know.
So Glenny, he just loves drinking Sopranos and
he said it. Entourage.
I'm a very simple man.
Simple guy.
I'm a very simple. I love food. I love barbecue. Oh. I love cooking.
You can cook? I've never seen. Well,
I've been trying. Yeah. I've been trying to learn.
We did get taught by Chef Green how to make smash burgers.
I did fucking really good at those.
You did make it very good.
You crushed it.
As sounds, I kind of like to make like remotely healthy foods attempt to taste good, which I never do, but I try.
Yeah.
We all do.
Like, I just got a cast iron pan recently. I got a cast iron skillet.
Ooh. Those are beautiful.
Cooking grilled chicken in there. Fantastic. Maybe chop up an onion. Throw that in there. One of my favorite things I've been doing recently, I go to my local butcher. They have a fucking turkey London broil. So I'll bring it home. I'll get the turkey London broil, which turkey's good. Turkey's healthy.
Turkey's great.
So it's like a loin of turkey. I'll score it, and then throw in the food processor, an onion, some fresh garlic,
garlic.
A little bit of oil. Can't go too much oil because you're trying to be hot. A little bit of oil, some seasonings, and then chop that, food process it up and pour it on top of the turkey.
Oh.
It, like, gets in the pores. And then when you cook it in the oven, it almost makes, like, a stuffing.
Oh.
And it's fucking really good. And it's kind of healthy.
I'm coming over.
Dude,
I'm coming over. I'm trying to cook. I need this specialty.
Live in Long Island or do you live in the city now?
I live on Long Island.
It's on Long Island, my friend.
I'm sorry. On
respect
Long
it, dude.
I do want to move out, but I live at home still. I do want to move out soon.
Do you commute every day to office?
Yeah, it's not bad. It's a 35-minute train ride.
No, that's not bad.
It's kind of nice. It's not a bad.
Yeah,
not a bad
relaxing.
Do you like your relationship at Barstool? Like, do you have a good one with Dave and all them?
Yeah. I mean, Dave like lives in Miami now, but I don't see him as often as we used to. But no, me and Dave are. I think we're good. Basically, I always say literally my whole life is just making sure Dave is happy. That's all.
Yeah.
As long as Dave doesn't hate me, I'm happy.
If your boss is happy, everything's
good. There's one person I care about, and it's Dave being happy. That's all I care about.
Yeah.
But like I said, I don't see him that often. He's in Florida now, so. Whenever I see him, I want to make sure.
Are they opening a Florida office?
I don't know. If they do, I might apply.
Yeah, is it just him down there, or are there other dudes down there?
It's just him, but I mean, I don't know if we're going to be in Florida.
Caleb's kind of there, too.
Yeah, Caleb lives out there.
We're going to see what if there is one, I will be applying.
You would apply for transfer.
I would love to. I mean, Delray Beach is one of my places that I'd love to live in. Maybe go down to Delray, get a car, drive down to Miami office every day.
I mean, it's only about an hour and a half. Life.
I'll do that.
Easy.
I don't mind being in the
Am I the only one that doesn't love Florida?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
It's too humid for me.
It's hot.
It gets hot, but
there are perks for sure. I just don't like stickiness. Like, I like LA because it's not humid.
It's ever. Very, very
it's
so
humid, dude. I went to a wedding last week in New Orleans.
Ooh, that's
cool. I was the sweatiest man I've ever seen. I felt so bad. So they did a fucking outdoor wedding.
I was
wedding.
The sweatiest man I've ever seen.
So it was in Baton Rouge, sorry. So we went to New Orleans before that. Then we went to Baton Rouge for the wedding. And it was an outdoor wedding. And then we go inside to do the friggin' to do the cocktail hour. And I take a picture of my buddies. It was like one of my girls from high school. Like my best girl from high school. So all my friends there. We take a picture and I look at the picture. I'm like, holy fuck, I didn't even realize. Like, you can just see your ball.
The sweat.
Yes, it's a ball of sweat.
Yeah, sweat through
death.
It.
Death. Yeah. That Louisiana humidity was out of bounds. I wanted to cry.
I gotta get down there.
Last time I was there, it was pretty humid.
The thing about New Orleans, though, I enjoyed it.
It's special.
But the food is.
But I would never go again. I would just rather go to Nashville. Nashville's closer to New York. I'd rather just go to Nashville.
There's like a specific culture there that's awesome and like.
But the food, like I've always just being like a Food Network guy, being a travel channel guy, I've always like enjoyed the Cajun stuff on TV.
Right.
And finally getting to have it authentically, it was.
I got a Cajun spot for you out here.
It blew my dick off.
It'll be the best Cajun food you'll ever have.
Did you go out like on the, what's the street called?
Bourbon Street.
Bourbon Street at night?
Yeah. I was there on a Wednesday, Thursday, so it was still fun. But it was like, like I said, it's like Broadway and Nashville, just not as fun.
Yeah.
So coming from New York, I could either take a 2.5-hour flight to New Orleans or an hour and a half flight to Nashville.
And Nashville.
What would you rather?
Much easier, man.
But I mean, it was like the jambalaya, the authentic jambalaya I had. Shout out Coop's place on Frenchman Street. It was so good.
This place makes bisque.
I'm 25 years old. I've been waiting 25 years to have authentic Cajun, and it was fucking
lived
awesome.
Up.
It's good.
It was
it's
so
very good.
Cajun food is just, I mean, they're all basically the same thing, like an etouffee, a jambalaya, and a gumbo.
Shrimp
are all the same like
po-boy?
Variation. A po'boy is literally just a sandwich. That's one thing I woke up. But
It's just a sandwich.
And etouffee, gumbo, and a jambalaya are kind of all very similar. Yeah. And they're all just so good.
It's special, man.
Crawfish. One of the places I went to had a... They had crab meat stuffed jalapenos.
Oh, my God. Don't tell us about crab.
Yeah. It was... I'm a crab whore. I know you're Maryland guys. So I'm a crab whore. I'm a whore for a crab.
Big, big crab.
I'm woke guy. I have, like, a thing... Like, if I were to say my best, my top foods, like, the if you were to offer me the best of the best of a food, a crab cake would maybe be up there for me. Like, if I could have the best crab cake in the world, I would love to have that. The best fresh mozzarella in the world, maybe.
Ooh, wow.
I used to date a girl in Baltimore. That's how I know Noah. Her family and me went to Ocean City one time, and they got, like, crab with, and it had barbecues. Like,
oh,
seasoning
yeah,
and Old Bay
that,
all
yeah.
over it.
The
and I swear to God,
thing.
It's the best thing
Old
I've ever
Bay,
had.
Old Bay, what a beautiful
treat.
Thing.
I buy Old Bay all the time now.
They just made Old Bay goldfish.
How are those, by the way?
They were
perfect.
Fucking delicious.
Perfect.
Old Bay is out of this world. So
great season.
You ever have, like, the crab fries?
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Like, dude, there's crab everything in Maryland. There's crab pretzels. Yeah. There's crab mac and cheese. There's crab, like, anything
what's
you
your,
can imagine.
What's your take on soft shell crabs? Because I'm a big fan.
You know what I want to try?
I
not that it's
am
a Maryland
not
staple.
A, I'm not a big fan.
Is it the texture, though? What's
it's
the
texture that
okay,
fucks me,
I get
dude.
It.
I can't do it.
I get it.
I can't
I
do
still,
it.
Like, I dream of this, like, fucking crab that we had.
Yeah.
And it was so fucking good.
Even, like, the crab dick growing up at the green turtle.
Oh,
so
my
good.
God.
The green Shout turtle.
The green dude. Turtle.
The green turtle.
I spent a lot of time I want to try Baltimore-wise, though, pit beef. I've never had a pit beef.
Oh. Okay.
You can get pit beef
here. The Wire, that means. You know about the pit beef?
I watched, like, one episode of The Wire and never picked up on it.
What the fuck?
I just know from Travel Channel.
Yeah,
you got to watch
true,
The Wire.
True.
It's literally the greatest television
that,
show ever.
That one pit beef right next to Security Spider.
The huge one.
The Sopranos is the greatest show.
I just read it.
Wire's up there. Wire's
like
very
close. I mean, everyone always says Sopranos and The Wire.
I just,
and it's a great cast, too. I mean, yeah. I watched one episode. I was like, holy fuck.
I just read an article.
I didn't know Elba was in it.
Dude, young Michael B. Jordan.
Yeah. Like, young Michael B. Jordan, obviously.
I just read a thing that 68 different countries of critics voted for the best TV show of all time, and The Wire won.
Obviously, who's the other guy? That passed away.
Got,
that was
I mean,
great
everybody.
Actor.
Michael
K. Williams. Yeah.
Awesome
Method
actor.
Method Man's in it. You got everybody
yeah,
in that
like,
shit.
There's a lot.
And Michael K. Williams.
I even like the white people season. Like
the season two?
Season
down
two?
The docks.
Down at the docks.
Yeah,
it's
the
like
slow ass season.
Dom from Entourage is in it.
Yeah, he is. He's got a big role in that.
Wendell Pierce is in it. He's a great actor.
It's Oh, man. What's
I was actually watching an Anthony Bourdain episode the other day. Wendell Pierce was
in
New Orleans guest. Oh, Bourdain?
Yeah.
Bourdain's one person that I saw.
Confidential.
I love him
in
Jack
Ryan. My favorite books of
I walked by him in the city one day, and I didn't say anything, but I saw him. It was like a month before he committed suicide.
No.
And
oh, wow.
That's wild.
But, it was, but he's like he's one of my top
yeah,
people.
He's too. A legend.
I mean, who doesn't love Bourdain? But friggin'
Confidential, that book just like...
Have you ever watched the Bradley Cooper chef movie?
I've not.
It's good.
Oh.
I actually recently...
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
I recently, just for the first time, watched Chef with Favreau.
And that one, dude.
Amazing.
What a fucking movie.
I remember I was living in... New York City at the time, in East Village, and I walked to that AMC or that theater in Soho, and I saw it like midday, and I was like, "Bro, holy shit, that was amazing!"
Favreau is a guy that we don't realize what a literal legend.
Legend.
We were talking about this the other night. He changed cinema because he created the Marvel Universe.
I mean, he's low key like the king,
one of the best writers of all time.
There's no Marvel Cinematic Universe the way that we know it now without Jon Favreau,
and he's doing Star Wars now. He did
Star Wars,
MCU.
But Swingers.
He directed Elf. He's a
legend. I didn't know
dude.
That.
That's a good point.
Yeah,
you should watch the movies. That
I mean,
made
everything
us on Netflix.
Yeah. Swingers, Elf, couples, all the Vince Vaughn movies. The Breakup. Is he in the Breakup? He's in the Breakup.
Yep.
He's in the Breakup.
And
he's
all
like,
all the
I'm begging in the sun like a Tijuana whore.
Yeah.
Friends, fucking, and then the whole MCU thing. He's not doing Star Wars. Like, Favreau is low key like
insane.
A fucking trailblazer.
Are you an MCU guy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's like a few I haven't seen, but I went to Endgame Friday night by myself.
I saw it five times.
It was
yeah,
so
he's
good, bro.
He's deep.
Yeah, I'm so actually good. For the first time in my life behind. I haven't watched Moon Knight or Miss Marvel.
I watched the three shows that came out first. What was that? Catherine with the Shoulder.
WandaVision
was awesome, and Loki was great. I watched all three.
I liked all.
There are like some. I actually haven't. I haven't seen the Ant-Mans, and I haven't seen. Doctor
oh, you gotta
Strange's.
Watch the first Ant-Man.
Ant-Mans are great.
And I haven't seen the Doctor right. Strange's yet. But my God, man, they're fucking awesome.
The Ant-Man got me into Marvel because I. Had just moved here and he was working and like midday I was just like fuck it I'm gonna go to a movie and I went to Ant-Man and got hammered and just had I snuck a Chipotle burrito in and I'm just sitting in Ant-Man just watching it with like two beers on my side and like
that's awesome
it was pretty great.
Like great
and I was like oh my God I love Marvel
I mean, the thing about Marvel too is there's a lot of shows.
For me, a little one.
Sorry. Oh yeah, there's a lot of shows I'll watch where like they don't friggin' they don't serve you correctly.
Yeah.
Like Sopranos. Sopranos is one of those shows. I love it. Right. But there's a lot of stuff at Sopranos where obviously when Melfi gets raped, you want her to tell Tony.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When Melfi gets raped, obviously. And the thing about Sopranos is though, they don't do that. And Endgame is a movie where like everything you wanted to happened.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was fan service. But that's what it was supposed to be.
It was fucking awesome.
It was the perfect wrap up.
I mean, when Cap picks up
that or No Way Home were like my top excitement for movies.
No Way Home, I almost cried in the theater.
You know it's all happening, but I was still like, holy
that's
shit.
Crazy. Even going into it knowing it's gonna happen, and you're still
I'm also,
that hyped.
I'm also like a fucking idiot. Like I was watching No Way Home, like when Andrew Garfield runs through the portal. I was like, I thought it was gonna be Tom Holland. I was like, is it? I didn't pick up
but
on
you
that.
Knew Toby and
Mark. I knew they were in it, but I thought that's was. I didn't realize that was gonna be the end.
Oh no, I knew. I was like,
and
oh, that's
I'm
not
also
Tom.
Actually, I'm also actually woke. I'm a Garfield guy.
So I think everybody's a Garfield.
Great actor.
I really
realized. Well, no, I'm saying Spider-Man.
Like, I was into the Marvel universe when I didn't see that opening like week with you, like I normally do. I always see it opening week and all the people in the people go. Fucking nuts.
That's what
kind of
makes it great when you see it opening night and people are like, oh! Yeah.
I was on tour at the time, so we came back and I saw it like 2 weeks after it came out. And I saw it at the fucking comfy movie theater, the one I pick. And I was that person in the theater. Like when they all got together, like everyone was quiet. I'm in my seat going, oh shit! Yeah. Like getting pumped. And no one in the theater was excited. I was like, oh my God, I'm that fucking guy.
When we saw Endgame opening night,
I really do love
you
this.
You two looked at me and you're like, yo, chill out. I yelled real loud at one point.
Endgame opening night was awesome. Like when he does the Avengers Assemble, the theater would fucking.
It was awesome.
It's genius he never did it the whole time.
Holds the
he never saw him say it.
I mean, it's really all of them.
Chris Evans might be my like Miles Teller kind of guy.
Really?
I fucking love it.
Like, what movies do you like Evans from outside of Cap?
Gifted
is one of the greatest.
God. Adorable.
It's the She's most so adorable movies. I mean, I like a lot. He did this rom-com with Michelle Monaghan that I love. What about Cellular back in the day with Statham?
Actually, Knives Out.
Knives Out's great.
You know, it's a good movie. I was actually talking to them the other day about it.
He's just that dude, though.
About it. One of my favorite rom-coms of all time. She's Out of My League.
Yeah.
Great.
Awesome
Fantastic
movie.
Movie.
Classic.
He did a movie. I watched it like a few years ago. He did an indie rom-com with Alice.
With her, yeah. He directed
it. Great.
That.
It was a great movie.
Yeah, he directed that.
But
that's the one in the subway with.
They're meeting like New York, and they just have like a nice night together. And you don't know if they're gonna get together.
He's got a rom com with Playing It Cool with like Topher Grace and Mackie and all those people. It's good.
Speaking of just like wonderful rom coms, you know what, the best is the end of the breakup when you don't know if
perfect
they're gonna get back together,
ending.
But like
we were,
you know,
perfect
we,
ending.
We just together. Rewatched it the other day.
They didn't need to get back together.
You don't want a resolution.
Also,
then.
Some of the greatest one liners in movie history, I think.
Like Gary on the kick.
My
show.
Sister's going Gary through a lot
on the kick trip
of dick.
The breakup's so good. The Vince Vaughn is like I always have my like, so I have my comedy rankings in my brain where I'm like, my number one, I think the funniest person of all time is Seth Rogen because he like does everything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, that's the thing I feel like it's weird to say.
I love Rogen, but I feel like he's teetering and pretentious too much. For
but
me.
He's the one who does everything, so I don't know if we consider. Like, I think in every role he's in, and I know he's canceled, so no one judges me.
Oh,
but. Everything James Franco does comedically,
he's
fucking so funny.
Oh, he's great.
Yeah.
Like, this is the end. He's the funniest character in this year.
100%. Well, we don't have to get into it.
You ever seen Why Him? Why Him? The Interview? James Franco, his comedic roles is so fucking funny.
I mean, he's in that camp of the, I mean, McBride for me.
I mean, that he's number one. We say number one all the time.
But
number one always just means like top 10.
Yeah.
No, he's like actually number one. There's no one funnier than McBride. In the world.
I like McBride how he teeters in drama too. Like McBride does like he did fucking Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just think of that of the jerk off scene in the
movie.
And that's the funniest scene of all time in history.
Perfect.
Bar none. Yeah.
I can't believe they got Emma Watson to do that.
Like just the way he talked when they got Emma Watson, he's like they're like they think he's like gonna like fuck, he's like gonna fuck with her. He's like. I just had a lot of questions about how he made that major motion picture. he's just the way he just delivered. He's the best.
He's special. He's pounding down is special.
He's pounding down.
Righteous Gemstones.
You know, honestly,
Vice Principals. I fell off on.
One of my favorite shows of all time is Vice Principals. I love Vice Principals.
It's excellent.
Mainly because it's like
it's
they shot it all in one, and it's everything. You got mystery, you got action, you got comedy, and he's just perfect.
The new one is great.
Gemstones is great. It's getting so weird.
Yeah, obviously. The first season, coming into it, you're like, oh my God.
But I love, I mean, they all went to film school together. All those Rough House guys that make those
Jody Hill, right?
Jody Hill, David Gordon Green, all
just
those guys.
Just as funny for me, Jake Johnson. Yeah. But he doesn't do as much.
I don't know much Jake Johnson's shit, but like what he's in,
Is that New Girl guy?
Yeah, New Girl guy. I love him. I like him in Minx. I like him in everything he does, really.
Minx was good.
He just, like, he hasn't had that, like, Eastbound and Down kind of moment.
But I'm trying to think. Like, obviously Sandler is, like, if I ever saw Sandler.
We played basketball with Sandler once.
You played basketball with Sandman?
Yeah.
Yeah,
like, Sandler's number one.
Me and him guarded him. But... me and Sandler guarded each other for, like, two games. It was pretty. I was, like, in shock.
They didn't even want to play.
Like, dude, drive to the hole right now.
I was like,
they didn't even want to play. We had just played two games.
Taking my shoes off. We had just played a couple games.
We were tired, hungover.
And somebody's like, yo, you guys want to run? And I was like, nah, I'm cool. And then I think
he was like, yo, no.
And I look up and I'm like, yeah, I'll play right now.
Yeah.
We saw it was Adam. We have to play.
Should we do this? The Sandman. I mean, he's up there with.
Oh, shit. Sorry, I don't have a shot glass for you.
Salud.
One of my sleeper favorite movies, Rain Over Me.
Yeah, it's a heavy one, too.
He's good at that.
Sandler is a fucking legend. I mean, he can do anything, I think.
You know what's one thing I always say? I always say Big Daddy is the most beloved movie of all time.
It's one of my favorites by far.
Like, there's not a person in the world, it may not be the best, but there's not a person in the world that hates Big Daddy.
Yeah. If you hate Big Daddy, fuck you.
It's so funny. You forget how funny Big Daddy is.
Dude, it's hilarious.
It's such a good movie that you forget how funny it is.
Me and my friends always do quotes.
Like, we love when Rob Schneider comes in and he sees the fat guy and he's like, you ordered 3 cheesecake. we always say you ordered 3 cheesecake.
Do we like Rob Schneider as a whole?
I think he's hilarious.
Yeah.
Do you?
He's so.
I mean, we got what? We got Big Daddy.
He does a lot of political. Longest Yard.
Bruce Bigelow was hilarious.
Fuck anyway.
We got.
He's not in Longest Yard. He's got like one scene, doesn't he?
But he plays the Waterboy.
That's all he needs.
He plays in Waterboy. But I mean, Schneider's great. I mean,
you can do it.
Yeah. The whole like allure of like the Sandler verse is just great.
He looks out for his boys.
Yeah, that's the best thing.
That's like
bringing his homies.
That's like the goal, really. In life,
it is.
But it's like his guys have all stepped up. They're the funniest,
and they're fucking
people.
Funny. Like Peter Dante is fucking hilarious.
God. He's a
Jonathan Loughran is so
has
funny.
Has he ever done anything without Adam?
Grandma's Boy.
That was Happy Madison production.
Yeah. But Peter Dante is so fucking. You know what's a Sandler movie that people hate that I think is like fucking hilarious?
Funny People.
I like Funny People. That's My Boy. Have you ever seen that?
That's My Boy is insane.
That's my one liners
in that movie are crazy.
So funny, and no one fucking
Little
talks
Nicky
that.
Is a classic.
Yeah.
I say Seth Rogen's the best. Obviously, the Sandman's the best. Yeah. But
they're up there.
You gotta credit
Judd Apatow a lot too, though.
Dude, that's the thing. Do I say Judd is better, funnier than Seth Rogen? I don't know.
I mean, dude, Knocked Up, 40-year-old virgin.
The thing about Seth Rogen is that he's not the funniest person in any of his movies,
except maybe
Night Before.
Right.
Obviously, Night Before. He's hilarious.
He's pretty good in Long Shot. I like Long Shot a lot.
Long Shot.
What a wonderful plane movie.
Yes, that's a good plane movie.
What a beautiful movie. That's one of my favorite.
Can we just start Sausage Party?
So funny.
So good.
So funny. The Nick Kroll in Sausage Party
is
so fucking funny.
No, the bit where it's like Ed Norton as
as the bagel?
The bagel and it's like the Jewish war that's going on in Israel. And it was so funny.
I mean, Nick Kroll is a guy, too, who's so absurdly underrated.
I'm a big Siegel guy, too. Jason Siegel.
Jason Siegel's great. I wish he would have stuck with comedy a little more.
Yeah, he wanted to be taken too seriously.
Like, just thinking of Nick Kroll, like Bobby Bottle Service.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall is top five movies.
It's me,
easily.
Bobby Bottle Service, a.k.a.
So funny.
Bobby Bottle Service.
We've gone over all of our tops, and like right now I think we're like 20.
We've had like 20 tops.
Go, the best.
I'm trying to think of who
so
it actually is.
It's so hard not to call them the best because they're all so good at what they
all
do.
All worthy.
Even Zach Galifianakis and Hangover.
Yeah.
Alan
I mean,
the Hangover.
Jack Black
Dude,
is a
Hangover
fucking...
Would not,
I'm not a Jack Black guy.
Hangover really? Would not swing today.
Hot take.
So I have a take. I always say it.
Has Jack Black done anything last however many years?
He was in Jumanji.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on, what are you going to say?
Here's one thing I always say. I think Superbad is the funniest movie of all time.
Agreed.
And Hangover is the best comedy of all time, if that makes sense.
It does.
I think Hangover is the best comedy. It's a fucking great movie. But Superbad, you can't talk
Where do you
Superbad.
Throw Old School?
Old
that
School,
mix?
That's what I'm saying. It's very
was
hard.
Old
to
school,
me,
were
you
too young
two.
For
Old Wedding
School?
Wedding
Crashers. That came out in 03. I was 7.
I was at the age when Old School that my cousin showed it to me.
Yeah.
and there were boobs in it, and I was like rewatching it and like trying to see boobs.
I mean, like
all
my dad, thankfully, like, brought. I remember my dad always tells me I was 11 years old. He brought me to Superbad. He was like the looks I was getting. Superbad. Because Superbad, when you watch it, it's not watching.
Very my mom. Very
dude,
you
know. I have one of the funniest Superbad stories. We had this.
What year did that come out?
07.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, I was a senior in high school. Yeah.
When it came out on DVD, it was obviously the only thing kids in high school talked about. And we had this, we all signed up for this, like, sports class that was just a joke in high school. And it was just, like, all my friends and me, and the teacher was just a pushover. And he told us we could watch a movie that day. And he told us we couldn't watch Superbad. And so he let us watch I Am Legend. And he walked out of the room and somebody switched the DVD with Superbad.
Hilarious.
And he came back in the room. And this was like a big, fat West Virginia man, like loud voice, like just one of those voices. And he saw it on the screen and fucking flipped shit. And
it's
still like one of my best memories of high school. This dude just freaking out of us, like taking advantage of him for it. It was so funny.
I mean, Superbad is a movie that I try to not let myself watch it too often because you don't want to oversaturate it. Then when
exactly.
You don't want to oversaturate. Just how funny it is. That's the thing. I love movie quotes. Like I live on movie quotes. Yeah. I'm a movie quote whore.
Our pets' heads are falling off.
That's why you got to move to LA because you would fit in perfectly with our movie.
I'm just such a movie quote whore.
This is what we do.
These are the movie guys.
I just
I
sit
see
around.
Them,
I would.
But
I would like to announce.
I just sit around
I'm
and quote
my first movie.
Oh really?
Right.
On the Hallmark channel.
Oh, hell yeah.
That's amazing, man.
What's it called?
I don't know.
All right.
I haven't gotten anything yet. I just got asked to be in it. It's like, you got speaking lines and everything.
You got lines?
Yeah.
We're a watch party for that, for sure.
100%.
We'll, like, drink wine and...
I think it films in August. I'm waiting to hear on that, but...
Wow.
Oh, yeah, brother.
That's awesome. Congrats.
Yeah.
This was fun.
Yeah, we did it, guys.
Are we retiring?
Is there anything... I think we...
I'm enjoying this. Are we done?
I could...
We're, like... How long in right now?
Well, we're cutting out the beginning stuff. And we're going to start on Miles Teller.
We're cutting out the Teller talk?
No, we're starting on Teller. Because Teller needs to hear this.
Yeah. Teller, we
get Teller. Will Teller see this?
I will make sure the clips are directed for Miles Teller.
I'm worried. I don't want Teller to think I'm weird, though. Like, I just want to bro out.
Bro, but he, like, I've seen him out with his boys. Like, he's like
us. Yeah, he's a bro.
He gets after it.
You know what I hated a couple weeks ago at work? We
should message him right now.
We should. Can you message Teller right now?
Teller, we're talking like, about you live.
He actually
right
follows
now.
You. He doesn't.
He
follow
does me. Follow me. I, but I'm too scared to DM him. Like, hey, what are you doing?
Why?
Like, yo, bro.
You got a chance. Just
I'm in
get
LA.
Know your phone.
I'll do it.
Happily.
We'll 100% send the message.
I'm too scared.
100%.
I'm too scared. What
Why?
Would the message say? What would the message say?
What up, brother? I'm in LA. Let's fucking grab a drink. Yeah. He
he's
drinks.
Miles Teller.
Dude,
he
he's a normal human.
But he follows
human.
You
like,
because he likes
he's
you.
A normal. Like, that's what I've learned about any celebrity is they're normal humans and they like people being real and honest with them. Like, hey, man, I'm in L.A. Love to see you.
It's true.
Swear to God, man. I swear on anything.
You know what? I've had a few shots. I'm going to let you DM
us. Anywhere that I've
Big
gotten
moment.
With anyone
could,
in L.A. it's because I've just been.
Normal. Yeah, I want you to do it.
I'll do it.
But don't say I would love to see you. That sounds weird.
Hey, dude. I'm in L.A.
Yeah.
Should we grab a drink? Simple. To the point. Let's get after it. I'm okay with that, too.
Fuck yes.
Are we wrapped?
This is what no, we're still rolling.
Oh, baby.
We're DMing him live on the podcast.
I guarantee he answers.
He
he's
will.
Like, yeah, let's what are you up
he
to?
He has, you know, he has his own drink, too. The long drink.
He's got a
the gin long drink.
The gin
drink.
One is his?
Mm-hmm. He's like an investor.
I think I know
it.
People invested in that too, actually. Because I had it like a while ago.
My heart, I hope you know how fast my heart is.
Don't, dude, don't worry. Don't stress.
Dude, it doesn't matter.
You're in the mayor's hands.
You'll yeah, the mayor's got you.
Yeah, I do feel like more calm knowing Noah's sending it.
We've met him multiple times.
Mm-hmm. He's a good dude. He's like us.
All right, here.
Yes.
Hands.
Read us the live message, Noah. What are you saying?
I'm going to fucking puke right now.
Why? Dude. I'm just going to have my clip guy just show a clip of Glenny shaking.
I'm freaking the fuck out right now.
Come on, Noah.
I got kind of nervous for a second.
See, don't do it.
No, I'm joking.
Hey, man.
Hey, man.
No, not hey, man.
Hey, man? No, not hey, man.
You're not hey, man him?
Yo.
Big dog.
Yo.
No, you just got to get straight to the point, because this is what I've learned. You just say what,
but
like,
this,
I'm in L.A.
He's like the most famous person in the world.
No.
He's having a moment. He's having a great moment.
that he deserves.
I don't want to do this.
Let me do it. I'm just going to do Miles! Exclamation point.
Oh, God.
No, not Miles! Exclamation point.
You just got to start with I'm in LA.
But about like I'm in LA. Are you having some drinks on this beautiful Sundae? Something like that. I'm freaking. This is Miles Teller.
I would even plug his drink and be like, "You're trying to throw some long drinks back? Like, have him engage."
I'm gonna puke. What are you writing now?
No, you just gotta say, "Yo, I'm in LA. Like, I would love to grab a drink or something if you'd like."
He does.
I think it should be more.
That's
casual,
what I'm saying.
Though.
He obviously likes you, bro.
A couple weeks ago, I tweeted.
I DM'd Pat McAfee. The other day, because we follow each other, and like he's always like looked out for me and like posted my stuff, but I've never like messaged him and asked for he's gonna premiere.
Miles, I'm in LA. Do you have any time for a drink?
No,
that's too formal.
I'm not trying to fuck him. I just want to bro out.
I just did this with McAfee where I was kind of.
I'm in LA. Should we bro out?
No.
Give me this.
What, you're gonna do anything better?
Just be like. My dude,
hey, man, I'm just gonna do it right here.
I'm in LA for the day.
You said no, hey man. I said hey man already.
No, hey man.
Fucking turned it down.
Relax.
So like I'm in
Can
LA.
I handle this?
I'm in LA. I'm in LA for the day. Are you out here having some drinks?
Perfect.
I gotta stretch. I'm getting sweaty.
I'm gonna puke.
Right it's now. Very hot.
Are you coming in?
Yeah, 100%.
That's awesome. 150%.
Hey man, I'm in LA for the day. Are you around? I'm having some drinks.
That's exactly what I had to.
No. I'm having some
are
drinks.
Are you around having some drinks? Question mark.
Are you around for having some drinks?
Are you around having some drinks?
Yeah.
Are you around, comma, having some drinks?
Having some beverages.
Bevs.
Beverages, not bevs. I'm gonna let me throw up.
Throw a dick pic
He's
in there too, Joe.
If this ends up with me drinking with Miles Teller tonight, I will blow all of you.
Oh my.
I'm joining, first of all.
This is
hey man, I'm in LA for the day. Are you around having some beverages? Would love to get after it with you.
Perfect.
Not with you. Just say I would love to get after it. Or down to get after it.
No. Why would you say down? I'm going to say would love to get after it.
Would love to get it. Not with you. Just would love to get after it. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Message is sent.
Put the phone down.
No, I was saying I asked McAfee to premiere the Dear West Virginia video the other day, and I've never really like asked him for anything, and I was like really nervous to do it, and I just was like, I didn't say like, yo, I got a question. I just kind of said, I've got this song coming out. Would you premiere? And he messaged me back. And he's like, I'd be honored to.
That's awesome.
Like, I was like, fuck, that's exactly.
Yeah.
You just like, I'm so nervous in that moment. And then like when they say yes, you're just kind of like, oh yeah, he's cool as fuck. Yeah. Like,
it's Miles Teller though.
Yes. But like,
he's the most famous person in the world.
He's one of my favorite people in the world.
Same. He's one of my white whales. Like, I fucking love Teller.
We like him, but
I even liked Fantastic Four.
Miles Teller's like, I want to meet him, shake his hand, and be like, dude, I fucking love 21 and Over.
I mean, that's
what I want to do.
I haven't disliked many movies.
Mm-hmm. If I see this fucking
Me and Noah, we don't dislike movies.
If I see this red number one come up on my Twitter, I'm gonna puke.
Oh, it's gonna happen.
I'm gonna puke.
Dude, he's going to
He's always on Twitter too. That guy is always tweeting.
He probably gets you get a notification when someone that
if you,
you
follow,
follow
him yeah.
DMs you.
I can't think about this.
He lives I wonder if he still lives here. Cause he used to hang out at the same spots as us for a while.
We bumped into him at Gold twice and
Riley's. He definitely lived
he lives
there.
Out here.
That was a while ago though.
No more telling talk.
All right.
You're scared.
Why are you scared? It doesn't look, here's the thing I've realized. None of it matters. Like
I know, but what you're saying is like
unless you're
a
messaging,
guy,
dude,
like it's fine, but like it's still scary.
Yeah, I get it.
Unless you're messaging this guy like 10 times and being weird, like it's not.
No,
weird.
I'm not. I would never.
I know.
This is the only message you ever send. If he doesn't answer, then it's over.
Yeah,
it's over. You'll never be friends.
I feel like we have to extend this until he responds.
He's Let's go in the pool, and then we'll see this put up. I'm gonna puke.
And we've been going for a while. Is there anything else we would like to cover?
Glenny, what are you most excited about this year? What do you want to do?
Yeah, what's the future hold
year?
For Glenny Balls and OnlyStans?
I have no idea. I got invited to an OnlyFans retreat in Tennessee.
I heard about that last night.
You were saying
you were consoling.
I don't know if I'm gonna go or not.
We're live from the OnlyFans mansion also.
No. We're at 104 Ladies House, yeah.
The Madame's house.
The Madame.
Yeah, we're having a good time, and we'll see. Hopefully OnlyStans keeps going. We'll see what happens. Like we said, we got Adam 22. That he's the king of the horny verse. So I'm excited about that.
He is the king of the horny verse.
The horny verse.
I dumped that term last week. He's the king of the horny verse.
Been on the porn websites and seen his.
He's the king of the horny verse. So yeah, we got him. We got.
How did he transition to that? Because he was in rap for a long time.
Well, he went out. He started dating Lana of the Plug, and then they just started. They have their show now. It's like they just fuck.
Lana the Plug. I just don't know porn stars like that anymore. I've got like 5, and that's like all I look at.
We just DM Miles Teller.
Yeah, we did.
It happened.
I'm sitting here fucking puking my brains out.
We're waiting.
He's gonna respond.
We're pretty excited. Respond.
I'm actually gonna fucking puke.
Twitter.
Yeah.
Hey man,
I'm in LA.
I don't even want to look
Let's
because I'm scared if he like answers that. Hey man, I'm in LA for the day. You're around having some beverages. Would love to. I'm gonna fucking puke.
He's going to. What do you mean? Easy.
I'm gonna die.
Hold on, come here.
No.
What?
I don't want to.
Okay,
all right. No, she's good.
We're fine.
Fine.
What? I was gonna say get on there.
Nah.
Okay, that's fine.
Absolutely not. That's their call. I'm personally okay. It's their call.
Yeah, we're good.
No, I don't want you.
We're about to end.
We're waiting for Miles, and then we're gonna.
Let's go in the pool, and then if he answers, we'll come back.
I feel like what not knowing what's next is the right move.
No, I have no. I'm not. That's not how I roll. I'm not a planner.
You gotta feel
what
happens.
So we'll see what happens, but.
And you're moving to LA next week.
I'm moving to Nashville.
2 weeks. Yeah.
Right now.
That's the spirit.
Right now, I'm strictly moving to Nashville and just shitting bricks, thinking about Miles Teller, reading this DM right now.
That's how you end an episode.
Yeah.
All right, we're just gonna title this: Will Miles Teller Respond? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Glenny Balls, one of the greatest dudes in the world. All right.
I love doing a podcast. It was great.
Peace and love.